Hello and welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Fred here from Scriptcase speaking, and today we're going to see the JSON exportation of the release of a Scriptcase 9.4 number 27. Well, right now Scriptcase allows you to export JSON files in a few clicks. So I will show you during this tutorial how to do it. Basically, these JSON files allows you to transfer your information in a standard web format, and you can also import this into another system, for example, or another platform. Okay. One of the main features of this JSON file is that it is actually really easy to read, even for developers. Okay. So basically, this option works with grids and charts applications. In this case, I will show you a sample within the grid. Good, so let me show you how a JSON file looks like. So basically, this is a JSON file. I have right now installed a JSON viewer for my Google Chrome, and I can update this page. And this is how a developer can read actually this JSON file. Alright, so once a Scriptcase creates a new version, it also releases a new sample system. In this case, it's no different, so I will show you. We have here the Scriptcase 9.4 project, okay? You can find this project into the samples project of Scriptcase. We have here all the news of this version, 9.4, and we have here this JSON item, so we can click here in this item. And we have here a grid, a standard Scriptcase grid, including a summary, okay? And we have this option right here, the JSON exportation. So this is a new feature. So we can click here and see the settings. So first we can select the module that we want to export. We can export just the grid or the summary as well, or both maybe. We can also here add another option, for example, the regional settings of my application. And we can also here set up if we want to export just the title of the table or the label. Okay, remember that we have the standard table name, but we can change it into the labels of a Scriptcase. We also can add a password, and we can also set up the columns that we want to export. Okay, so let me generate a new file. In this case, I have 481 records, so it is pretty fast, as you can see here. So let me view my file. In this case, I have this view because, as I told you, I'm using an extension. Good. So if I open my download folder, I can see here my file. And this file right here is ready for being ported into different systems, platforms, and more. All right. Good, so let me go back to my Scriptcase. And as I told you before, this sample system is here in this sample project, okay? So you can import or you can make use of this project by clicking here this create button. Then you can create this project right here, okay? So you say I got this project already created. I will show you how it works. Okay, so let me open this project. Samples right here. And we can scroll down and we will see a folder. It says version 9. Version 9.4. We have this JSON folder. Okay, the application that was displayed before was this one right here. It says grid orders JSON. Okay, so we can edit this file. You can just create a grid. I'm just showing you the same sample that Scriptcase offers to you. Okay, all right. So the first thing is enable this option in the toolbar. Okay, here we have. You will see all the PDF, Word, Excel, and you will see this new option right here. So make sure that it's enabled right here. And we can set up here the settings. So let me go to the export options, export types. Then we have here the JSON file. So right here we can enable some settings for the final user. So we can, for example, create a password for the file, a defined password. We can also here modify the columns of this application for the exportation. And we have here some several options. For example, if we want just to export the grid or just the summary or both. Another interesting thing about this new version is the actual exportation process. We can find this process about 40% faster than before, okay? We also update the component of these exportations, and we can also export more records than before. Good, so I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you like it, please thumbs up, and I see you in the next time.